We've cued the music, and you know what that means. It's time for the Louis Herron Weekend Kickoff with Louis Herron.
At the end of the day, what's most important is to find the car you want that meets the expectations that you need for you and your family.
And Randy Beasley.
Of course, the weekend, you got folks maybe thinking it's going to be some nice weather to get outside and peruse the car lots.
And now here they are, Louis and Randy.
It is the final Friday of summer, and it is the weekend kickoff with Louis Herron in studio. Good morning, sir.
Just getting a little coffee.
A little caffeine.
That's it, man. Pick me up. A little pick me up. How are you?
I am wonderful. Yeah. Did you see the high school team that came in and played the Falcons last night?
What was that about?
Oh, my gracious. I could not believe it, and I'm just sitting there trying to figure out, you know, they almost won. Tampa Bay almost won last week. They were in the game. I know Carolina didn't have Cam Newton, but right. They were in that game for the end of the fourth quarter. I know the short week affects teams different ways, but that was unbelievable.
Well, what about old Devin Hester? Good gracious. Just when you think he's one man's trash, he's another man's treasure, huh? You guys are lucky to get that guy. How many more years do you think he's got left? Three? Two more years?
I don't know. I just hope he can stay healthy. He was. I hope it was just cramping last night. He was in the fourth quarter. He was limping around. But in fact, all the Falcons receivers were limping around late in that game. But hopefully, everybody's
they're
okay.
They're running wind sprints all night.
Yeah, it just warm out. But that was fun to watch. In case anybody's wondering what we're talking about, the Falcons beat Tampa Bay 56-14 last night.
And, that's huge.
And it wasn't that close, if that's possible. So we got that bad taste out of our mouth quickly after losing in Cincinnati. You're ready to get that one out of your mouth now after last week's Miami game.
Yeah, it was terrible to say the least. But we don't do well when we go to Buffalo. But Jim Kelly was coming back, announcing he's cancer free, which is awesome. And they had a new ownership change mentioned in his first home game, and everyone was crazy. Bills 1-0, so you know they got a chance to be 2-0. Miami looked terrible. You can't figure that team out.
Yeah, it's the NFL, but it is.
Every week is tough.
It is. It is a grind. It sure is. But so who does Miami play this week?
Kansas City.
Okay.
All right. At home. So we'll see how that goes. And who's Falcons? Who do they have next week? I don't know who they have. You should have that on the radio, right?
It's like 10 days we got off here. Okay, we're gonna regroup. I know they got to play the Giants pretty soon, but I don't think that's the next game. So,
what about high school football? What's going on in high school?
Well, high school tonight, all of our local teams are in action. Baldwin is on the road playing Thomasville, and our other teams are at home tonight. Another tough one. GMC Prep is hosting FPD. John Millage is at home with Piedmont tonight, and that's our game of the week tonight, 7:15 here on Country 102. So that's the local games. We won't even talk about Georgia and South Carolina. We just will just skip right over that.
Right.
It's amazing. Georgia up in Columbia is just anything and everything can and will happen, it appears. But Georgia will lick their wounds and get well this week against Troy, and then they've got Tennessee next week. So,
well, let's talk about some car business. We'll get right into it. You know, last week we talked about the sales process, you know, and we talked about kind of the importance of how customers can save some time and ultimately save some money. But we never really got past the meet and greet, which we can recap. And so when we come back, we'll get into negotiating and all those items as well.
Okay. All right, we got a lot to do today. The only other football note we want to mention, actually two games tomorrow we want to mention. Georgia Military will be hosting Middle Georgia State. That's a 12:30 airtime on Country 102. Georgia Military coming off a big win last weekend. Also tomorrow, Georgia Tech on the road to play Virginia Tech. That's on Sports Radio 1450, 10 a.m. pregame kickoff around noon tomorrow. So lots of football, as we always like to make sure we mention on the Weekend Kickoff with Louis Herron in studio here on Country 102 WKZR. It's 8:21. Here's Miranda Lambert. This is Country 102 WKZR. Our Bobby Brown Insurance Agency time is 8:25. Currently 67 degrees. It's the Louis Herron Weekend Kickoff with Louis in studio with us this morning as we get you ready for another big weekend. And all right, so we're going to jump right back where we were last week, talk a little bit. We're talking about the experience, right? So the car buying experience.
So what did you think about last week when we were kind of getting into it? Anything stick out so we don't have to recap the whole thing so we can get a little further? But what was some of the key highlights you remember?
Well, you know, in the past we've always talked about the preparation you do before you get in there. We talked about how long before you get bombarded, or you know, do you want them helping you out before you park the car? Or do you want them, you know, is five minutes too long? So, you know, just trying to get started in the process. And then again, it's all about if the salesperson, if you give them enough information up front, then you can save yourself a lot of time.
Well, and that's the only thing I really want to recap is that fact-finding stage. A lot of times, what happens is like we kind of use the metaphor about malpractice, you know, doctors and so on and so forth, you know, and I think, you know, doctors don't prescribe things without getting all the information so they don't make a mistake, of course, or wrongly appraise the situation. But I think the same thing is true for salespeople. The limited information they get from a consumer, Randy, it promotes them to kind of assume. And then they start going in a completely wrong direction. Now they're prescribing medication for a situation they don't need. It's not going to fix the problem. And so now all of a sudden, consequently, they spend 3-4 hours with the customer. And at the end of the day, there's nothing more frustrating for a customer to get deep in the process and go, what the heck are we doing? You mean I've wasted 4 hours? You could have told me that at the beginning. Why? You know what? Give me my keys. You know, and the next thing you know, their experience is awful. The salesperson's sitting there because either A, he didn't ask the right questions, or B, the customer withheld him. And I think the customers withhold information because their past experience predicts their current behavior. If you've gotten shim-shammed in a deal before, or you felt like you got taken advantage of, or something didn't go well, you're more reluctant to give information because you feel like that puts you in a corner last time. Would you agree with that?
Sure. That's the past experience is a big part of it, and you've got to decide before you go in. If you know what you want, you can make this process a lot smoother and a lot quicker. And both sides can be at blame, but the best way to do it is to know what you want to do before you go in.
And so when we're talking about selecting the car, that's kind of where we left off last time. We're talking about the selection of the car, Randy, is probably more deals are missed because of trade-ins than anything. But the second thing is we're on the wrong car. And what do I mean by that? Well, a salesperson is trying to convince a customer that this car will work for them when the customer either A is not that honest and doesn't shut that down right at the beginning, or they get on a vehicle that's just too much money. And in the fact finding stage and the selection of the car stage, getting the needs assessment, understanding the deal, understanding what the customer wants, understanding what they need, what the financial arrangement may be, not the interrogation. You don't want to interrogate somebody and you shouldn't feel interrogated. But there are some key elements that they realize if you know that really and truly you're coming out of a $263 payment and you're coming out of a Jeep Compass, okay, and it's 3 years old, and you're paying $263 a month, and you find yourself on a Suburban, 2014 Suburban, which is a $50,000 car, and think that you're going to be at $263. Obviously, we're going to go drive the car. We're going to go through the process. You're going to fall in love with it. You're going to love it. It's a lot better than the car you had. You're going to sit down, and they're going to show you $700 payments, and you're going to be like, what? This is not – we're not even in the ballpark. So the selection of the car is so critical. Couple of components I think are important before we go to the break. Finding the right car, understanding the needs. Again, go back to a real estate agent, you know, and or a mortgage broker trying to find out the right needs for your home that you're going to buy. You can't look for a 3,700 square foot home when really the house you just sold was 1,700 and there's really been no increase in job. The increase household income hasn't increased that much because obviously it's not going to fit the budget, the criteria. But if you want to upgrade and you want to get more features than you had, obviously you got to understand what your limits are. All right, but you don't want to go above and beyond what you can afford to pay, and you do that by doing the research. One of the things that you know, again, if you don't remember, one thing that I tell you, for every $1,000 you finance, for every $1,000, it's going to roughly cost you $23 to $25 a month. So if your bottom line is $10,000, then you know you're going to be around $250 a month. Now, we talked about negative equity in other shows. If you're carrying $3,000 of negative equity at $25 per thousand, you got a $75 car payment before you select a car. So understand that, and again, this part of the research, when you're going in that selection process, finding the right car, doing the math in your head, kind of getting an idea. I will tell you, the car business is very creative. We got term, we got rate, we got coupons in F&I, or excuse me, the finance and insurance department. I use the acronym, but we've got things we can do that can make the payment lower than you thought. So you want to hang around to find out what the dealership can do for you in that capacity. But math is still math. $1,000 per finance is going to cost you roughly $25 a month.
All right. We'll be talking more about that, more about the buying experience, and about how you can save time and money. Country 102 WKZR, the Louis Herrin Weekend Kickoff. And we'll have more in just a moment.
I'm Matt Cook with the Georgia News Network. The GBI is investigating the shooting death.
There's Blake Shelton on Country 102, 837, and this is the Louis Herrin Weekend Kickoff, trying to get you ready for the upcoming weekend, final weekend of summer. Yeah, fall officially arriving Monday, so going to have some nice weather, looks like, next week.
Yeah, it looks good.
Some 70s all week. And 50s next week, maybe.
And that's nice. I'm ready for the heat to kind of subside a little bit. What about you?
Yeah, I'd like an extended autumn, though. I don't want to go right
straight
into winter.
Let's
have some nice fall weather for a while. 68 degrees, and Louis is with us in studio this morning, and we're talking about the buying experience and about how to make it a little more pleasant.
A little better than a dentist.
Yes.
Right? If we can do that, we're making some headway. I wish I could speak for every car dealer across the country, but unfortunately I can't. But I can speak for what I'm convicted about that I think would be good for the consumer. And listen, like we talk about, Randy, I mean, everything I'm sharing you can find. None of this in any way hurts the dealer. I think it creates a better relationship between the dealership and the consumer. Like I always say, consumers, we're in business to make a profit, and there's nothing wrong with that. What we want to do is we want to make sure that it's fair and reasonable, and you feel good about your experience, you feel good about the deal, you feel good about the car, you bought a good car, it's safe, it's reliable, it lasts a long time, and you know what, when you're ready to do it again, you felt so good about that particular dealer, you go back and do it again. And that's what we're looking for. We left off with the selection of the car. Again, and if you were listening before, two things that kill a car deal faster than anything is your trade-in and the wrong car. You can't be on the wrong car. So
Let me ask you this. How often do you have a situation where you've got somebody who is going to buy, they're eligible to buy, but they're buying too much car, and how can you walk that line where you can't tell somebody what to do, but they're just on a car that they're convinced they're going to get, and it just doesn't look right.
It's a horrible situation, because here's what happens. Two things either happen. A, you miss a car deal, or B, for the dealership, you take a huge hit on a car trying to force a deal. You're trying to cram a golf ball through a garden hose. You're trying to force this thing to happen. Dealerships are going to do whatever they can to make a deal. If there's any light of profit, the dealer's going to sell the car, unless it's a unique piece like a 2015 Corvette or, something that's like this low supply. Typically, when consumers are looking for vehicles that are high supply vehicles, cars that are sold daily, Civics and Accords and Sonatas and F-150s, I mean, where they get, there's a plenty of supply, they're going to do whatever they can possibly do to make that deal. So when a consumer's on the wrong car, you asked me the question, how often does it happen? 85% of the time.
Wow.
85% of the time, consumers are on the wrong car. The reason why they're on the wrong car is twofold. The first thing is the consumer's saying, I could give you a lot of information, but nope, I'm not letting you have it. It's in my pocket, and I'll show it to you when I want to. That's number one. Number two, salespeople in as a whole could be better trained, could harness their craft and work on it a lot better, so they can become extremely professional and proficient about the questions they ask. The key is, can I ask you a question, Randy, without offending you and get the information I'm looking for? For example, I could say something like, hey, that's a nice trade-in. How long have you had the vehicle? Well, I've had it for about 5 years. It was given to me by my dad, and then my dad drove it for a few years before that, so it's an 8-year-old car. Okay, or so I found out some information about the car, or it could be a late model car, 2 years old, and I was like, man, that's a beautiful car. I mean, that thing's almost paid for, and the answer could be, no, actually, I've got 3 more years left. Well, I've just asked the customer in a conversation way, do you still owe money on your car? Mm-hmm. But if I come right out and I say, hey, listen, how much money do you owe in the car?
Yeah.
The customer's going to look at me like, what does it matter?
Right.
Right? But if I'm a good professional sales representative, I'm going to do and ask the questions in a conversation-based way where I can help the consumer, A, save time, and help them structure the deal where we're not on the wrong car. I already know when I meet somebody on the lot, Randy, even being an owner, people recognize who I am or they've heard my name. I'm still extremely delicate. When I meet a customer at the lake lot all the time, I never ask customers, are you ready to buy? How much you pay a month? What do you want to pay a month? How much money you got in your pocket? How much cash you want to put down? You want to pay? Today, even in this day when I have probably a higher level of trust from most consumers that actually know that I'm there, I never get in that conversation because I'm not worried about that. What I'm focused on is thank you for stopping by. Appreciate the trust that you've put in us. What is it that brought you to the dealership? How did you know about us? Tell me the needs you're looking for. What's the reason why you're looking at a car? Is it a collision? Is it a birthday for somebody? Is it time to upgrade? Is the car giving you trouble? What are your needs? What is it that if you could have the car your way, if you had 100% your way, what would be the arrangement you would want? And when I ask that question, I get all kinds of answers. I've never interrogated them, but it's just the way to communicate with a guest where they feel like, and again, you can't fake sincerity. You either feel like you want to help the customer or you're all about the car deal. Mm-hmm. And that's where I think a lot of salespeople, and really I hate this, it's not any fault of their own because a lot of people are trained that way. We're training these guys every Saturday morning, let's go out there and sell a car today. Go sell a car. So what do? Consequently, they weed out all the non-buyers looking for the one guy that's going to sell. So how do they do that? Hey, how are you? My name is Louie. You looking to buy today? Nope, not today. Move him out of the way. Hey, how are you? My name is Louie. What's your name? You looking to buy today? No. Third customer, yeah, actually, if the price is right, and so you're training these guys to go out, which is crazy, and go find the buyers, which means you weed out all the non-buyers, which, like I always say, customers don't drive up on a Saturday because they're looking for milk or bread. Mm-hmm. They're not coming to get the prescription. This is not CVS. They're coming because they're interested in a car. And whether they're interested in buying a week, a month, it doesn't matter. What matters is, are you going to put your best foot forward and be committed to them and give them what they want so when they're ready to buy, they'll consider you? There's so many options out there. They can consider a lot of different people.
This is the Louie Herron Weekend Kickoff, and Louie is at the dealership. We're talking about Louie's Lake Lot, Lake Oconee Parkway near the Pyramid. And you can go by there and see Louie, see him today, see him tomorrow, and there most all the time.
That's right, every day.
Ball and chain.
That's it, man. It's hooked to me.
All right, we'll talk some more in just a minute. We're going to take another break here on Country 102, 68 degrees, and our forecast for today calling for partly sunny skies. We do have a slight chance for a shower or thunderstorm. We're going to warm up into the mid-80s this afternoon. Tomorrow morning will be partly cloudy with a low in the mid-60s. But we do have some milder temps coming next week especially. We're talking 50s as early as Tuesday morning. So get ready for it as fall is going to come in right on time, it looks like. This is Country 102 WKZR. This is Country 102 WKZR, 69 degrees at 8:47. And we'll be back to talk some more with Louie Herron on the Louie Weekend Kickoff coming up in just a moment.
Hi, this is Ed Weimer at Alliance Financial Partners with some important insurance information. Did you know that September is Life Insurance Awareness Month? Were you also aware that too many Americans do not have adequate life insurance protection? Here's the bottom line. A majority of American families either have no life insurance or not enough. This leaves them one accident or terminal illness away from financial catastrophe for their loved ones. If this sounds like you, call us at Alliance Financial for a full, no-obligation life insurance review. Alliance Financial Partners has the knowledge and resources to help protect your loved ones and set your mind at ease. With access to over 40 different life insurance carriers, Alliance Financial Partners is positioned to find a solution to meet your needs. Call us today at 478-453-7526 for a complimentary evaluation. That's 478-453-7526. Call today.
We're with Daryl Black of Flooring America on Highway 22 West across from Williams Park. Well, fall is almost here, Daryl.
Right, Scott, and we're going to let some prices fall to celebrate the fall. So that it won't be the fall of Flooring America. It'll be the fall for the falling prices. If it was $30 a yard, now it's going to fall to $25. $25 is going to fall down to $22, and et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. Got some great buys on some flooring. Now's the best time to beat the pre-holiday fix-up rush. come now to Flooring America at 50 Highway 22. Got great specials on vinyl, carpet, anything you walk on. We got to hear your best price for home flooring anywhere in the Middle Georgia area.
How's the inventory?
Full, bulging. We need to get it down to normal levels. That's why we got the big sale going on right now. Hurry on down.
The Super September Sale at Flooring America of Milledgeville. You step it up, we step it down. Falling prices at Flooring America of Milledgeville, Highway 22 West, across from Williams Park.
69 degrees at Country 102, the Louis Herron Weekend Kickoff. Louis in studio with us today. We're talking about the car buying experience and about how to save time, how to save some money, and how to make the right deal.
Right. So we talked about the selection of the car. Excuse me. And we talked about how important that is. The next thing is the test drive. Now, let me ask you this. One of the toughest things for a salesperson, I'm going to tell you this, you won't believe this, but one of the toughest things for a salesperson to do is to get a customer to drive a car. Can you believe that? Customers do not want to drive a car.
They feel like it's a commitment, you think?
I don't know, but do you buy a pair of shoes without putting them on, or you just think they look good and you just kind of think about it? And I'm not even being facetious. I mean, I've been doing this 22 years. I understand why they don't or what they feel. But if you're in the market for a car, you know you're going to buy in a month, 2 weeks, 2 days, maybe even 2 hours. Who knows? Mm-hmm. You don't drive the car?
Well, let's talk now. Some people, especially first-time buyers or people, they may not know what. Let's talk about how easy it is to test drive. Like if they say, I want to drive this car, what do you need? You need the driver's license.
That's it.
What do you need?
That's it. We need a driver's license. That's it. Copy of the driver's license, and you got to be of age, you know, and you're ready to go.
Okay.
I mean, it's just like if you go into the jewelry store, you look in the box, you know, the bride to be says, I like that one. Okay. We don't keep it in the box. We say, can we see that one? And then she puts it on the finger. She mm-hmm. sees how it looks, how it feels, how you know, it's the same. Like I said, with shoes, you see a pair of shoes or you see a nice dress or you see a nice suit. It's not like you go, that's nice on the rack. I'm going to take that one. You're going to go put it on. You're going to see what it is. I don't understand.
Maybe they don't trust themselves once they hear that motor running and they have their hands
could
on
be.
The wheel, you know,
it could be. But at the same time, especially when it comes to pre-owned automobiles. Okay. You got to drive a car. I don't know if you remember the story I told you. I was selling Hondas way back in the day. And I had a customer. I was in Atlanta, and I was in Douglasville. I had a customer come from Alpharetta. So Alpharetta to Douglasville, it's about a two-hour haul. He was buying a brand-new Odyssey. He wanted to come when he got off work. So we're there at 9:30, 10 o'clock at night. Typical car scenario in Atlanta, Georgia. Okay. Mm-hmm. So we're there. Sales manager's like, look, dude, Louis, dude, let's go. Let's speed up the process. Let's go. Let's go. Let's get it. So I offer for the guy to take a test drive. He said, no, I'm not worried about it. It's a brand new car. You know, it's a brand new car. Not a big deal. I know it's what I want. All right. We do the paperwork, do everything. It's close to 11 o'clock at night. Managers are locking up everything. He leaves, takes delivery of the car, goes down the road. Managers leave. I'm in the back getting my car. I'm getting ready to pull out. Well, guess who pulls back up?
Doesn't like the car.
Yeah, it's Mr. Patel.
Doesn't like the way it drives.
Mr. Patel comes back. He comes back. I'll never forget this. He comes back. He says, I don't want the car. I said, what's the problem? I said, was something wrong with your paperwork? He says, no, everything's fine with the paperwork. I don't want the car. I said, what's wrong with the car? He says, the car is, I don't know how the terminology, but basically he was saying spiritually it wasn't right because when he drove down the road, the car was bumping, 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 bumping. I said, well, sir, it's a brand new car. It's got to be something very minor. It's a brand new Odyssey. Odysseys are hot as fire at this time. I mean, it's a great car Honda makes. It's not a big deal. Nope, don't want it. I want my trade back. Well, managers are gone. So what am I to do, right? So I go get the guy's keys. I say, let me have your paperwork. I park the car on the side of the building. He leaves. Next morning, come back. You know what was wrong with the vehicle?
No, what?
The vehicle had sat and it had dead spots in two of the tires. That was it. Brand new vehicle. Could have been handled easily. We lost the deal because this guy didn't want to drive a car. Okay. So two things happen. This guy continues his search to buy another car. Takes another 3 hours at another dealer. Okay. Go through there. Now, again, as a consumer, I understand how most of you feel. The faster you can get this done, the better off you are, right? Like going to the dentist. Who wants to do this? Mm-hmm. You've already given your information, your credit. You've already gone to the business office. I mean, this guy's got to go through that process. And we lost a car deal all because there was dead spots in the tires because the vehicle sat there for a month or 2 months without being driven. Who knows what created it? But the point is you've got to test drive the car. When you're driving a 4x4, 4x4, test drive the 4x4. When I can't express it, especially in used cars, drive the car, get a feel for the car, you know. Make sure you check the seats, the lumbar, all the ergonomics inside the dash. Make sure that everything's safe. Check your radio so you know exactly, you know, all those things are very, very important. But you'd be amazed, most people don't drive a car. So my tip is, make sure when you go to buy a car, it doesn't matter if you're buying that day, Randy, drive the car.
All right, we'll be back for one more break with Louie here in just a moment. Louie here in Weekend Kickoff. Country 102 WKZR, 69 degrees at 8:54 with Big and Rich. GMC Prep is at home with FPD. That's your high school games tonight. And now one more time with Louie Heron with us. Been in studio today, the Weekend Kickoff, and
it's back been fun.
One final break. Yeah.
You know, I'll tell you what, if you're listening now, catch us next week. We'll continue this because I think negotiating is going to be the funnest part. We still got to get to that. So we've kind of been walking through the sales process, understanding what the dealership's looking at, their point of view, and understanding from a consumer side what I think would be beneficial for you to save time, save money, get the best car you can, and actually go through the process with as minimal fear as possible, you know, and that's really the goal. I want to share with you also, too, if you're listening, you want a free car wash, come on out. We got some girls from Gatewood Middle School that are out there, free car wash. They'll take some donations out at the Lake Lot right there at 980 Lake Oconee Parkway next to the Pyramid. Come out there from 10 to 12, get your car washed. If you want to tip them a little bit for the school, that'd be great to just support you know, the local communities, any of the high schools, middle schools, you know, around Baldwin Green and Putnam County. So also just talking about the Lake Lot, I mean, you referenced it earlier, you know, me always being there, I enjoy what I do. I love selling cars, I love dealing with customers, and I love helping people get great deals. So come on by. If you want to just go to the website, louislakelot.com, save you a little trip. And I also challenge you to do this. You know, Randy, we talked about it, I think, a couple weeks back. We like to one-price our cars as much as possible, but really, don't just take what I'm saying for it. I want you to go to AutoTraderCars.com. I want you to plug in the car you're looking for if it's pre-owned, if you're in the market for a car. I promise you, we will pop up on page number one. We will pop up probably car number one, two, or three on every single car we got on the lot. I promise you, our prices are more aggressive than any, and I'm going to tell you how I know. Last week, we sold two cars from North Carolina. One car from Cumming in Forsyth County, another car from Dublin. All of these locations are hours from us. They don't come here because we're the most expensive. They don't come here because they want to buy a car in Lake Oconee, you know, off a rock lot. I promise you.
They don't come just because you're a good guy.
They don't. In fact, all five of those deals, nobody even knew who I was. So all I'm saying is for the local customers that are here in Baldwin County, local customers in Putnam and in Greene County and all of our Middle Georgia area, go to autotrader.com, go to cars.com, check out our prices. We've got over 60 cars in inventory, any make, model, Highline. I got Lexus, Mercedes, Audis. BMWs, Toyotas, Hondas, Nissans, Chevrolets, Fords, F-150s, F-250s. I'm telling you, go to AutoTrader, go to Cars.com, go to KBB.com, okay? Go to the sources you trust, and I promise you we'll be at the top of the list.
All right, sir, have a good weekend.
Let's go Dolphins.
Good luck on that.
Uh-huh.
9 o'clock, Louie here in Weekend Kickoff. Go by and see Louie on the Lake Oconee Parkway near the Pyramid. See him this weekend. 69 degrees, Country 102 is WKZR Milledgeville.
This is the